In this video today, we are going to talk about how long does ovulation last. We are talking about the ovulation calendar, how to calculate your ovulation, and how long does ovulation last. So stay with me as we talk about the time it takes for ovulation, when it has really happened, how long does ovulation last, after this message. Thanks a lot, my friend, for staying around. We are talking about how long does ovulation last. And before we go to the time taken for ovulation, we are going to first of all look at this example. It's an example of the menstrual cycle, and specifically it is covering the different phases of your menstrual cycle. You realize that if at all you start your periods, if you see your periods on first, this is just an example, but it could work for any day when you see your periods. So specifically in this cycle, it is a 28-day cycle, and assuming that you start seeing your periods on first, you see your periods on second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. The days you are seeing your periods are the days we call the days of your menstruation. So when we want to count your ovulation, when we want to assess and identify the day you are ovulating or the days you are ovulating, we begin from the first day when you saw your periods, that is day one, and then we count 14 days up to the 14th day. So specifically, this will be day one, day two, day three, day four, day five, six, seven, eight, up to 14. So day 14 is the day of ovulation. So when you ask me, what is the ovulation date for this particular client, for this particular woman, you realize that when she saw her periods on first, then her ovulation date is the 14th day. This works for women who are having regular cycles, 28-day cycles. In the video, the title is "How long does ovulation last?" Having talked about the days of menstruation, we've identified that these are the days you are menstruating, or this particular woman menstruated, then we've discovered that this is the ovulation date. First of all, we need to define the term ovulation. Ovulation simply means that your ovary, the follicles specifically, have released an egg. They've released a mature egg, and this egg normally lasts for 12 to 24 hours. So to answer the question, how long does ovulation last? Ovulation specifically lasts for 12 to 24 days. But we always said that even though your ovulation date is on 14th, still we give an allowance of the days before you see your ovulation. And then we also give an allowance on the days immediately after you've seen your periods. The days before your periods plus the ovulation date plus the days after seeing your periods are what we call your fertile window, or the unsafe days, or the days you are most likely to get pregnant. So in this video today, we have answered the question about how long does ovulation last. So we, having known that ovulation lasts specifically for 12 to 24 hours, then we shall understand that when ovulation has happened, there are many changes that are going to happen in your body. How will you tell that yes, now this is ovulation and it has happened? Specifically, when ovulation, or when the time for ovulation has reached, you'll realize that your cervical mucus, the mucus coming from your cervix or your private parts, is going to be very thick and it's going to be very slippery. Remember, when you are not ovulating, your mucus or your cervical mucus normally is, specifically, it's thin and it is dry. So when you are ovulating, your mucus normally is very thin, it's very thick and it's very slippery. The other sign of ovulation is that your body temperature will tend to rise. It will tend to spike up. What we call the basal body temperature is going to rise when you take your temperature with the thermometer. That is also another sign of ovulation. Next sign of ovulation is when you get these ovulation predictor kits and then you test your urine, you realize that the levels of LH are going to show on the ovulation predictor kits. Thanks a lot, my friend, for staying with me. We are talking about how long does ovulation last. GERALD MASSA, the health educator, is the name of the channel. Remember to subscribe and hit the like button and share this video so that many of our friends can get to watch this video. We are proceeding with our video after this message. Please keep watching. Thanks a lot, my friend. We are still continuing with how long does ovulation last. We've talked about ovulation. We've talked about when the days you started seeing your periods. And we have said that to get your ovulation date, specifically, you count 14 days. And on the 14th day, that is the day of ovulating, over the day of ovulation. So what is happening is this. When ovulation has happened, the next thing we need to do is, we always advise, if at all you are looking at getting pregnant, we advise that you be with your partner on the first day, or specifically before seeing your ovulation. We always advise that you be with your partner on the day before the ovulation date. So if at all today was 13th, and then tomorrow, giving an example, if today was 13th and tomorrow was 14th, which is going to be the ovulation date, we always advise that to increase your chances of getting pregnant, you be with your partner on day 13, the day before your periods. But still, remember, the egg stays for 12 to 24 hours. So still, you can be with your partner even after ovulation, because you just never know whether the 24 hours have elapsed or not. So chances are, you can still be with your partner. Your chances of getting pregnant can be increased. Like and share this video and share with our friends so that many of our friends can get to know this video, to see this video and to watch and get this knowledge. GERALD MASSA, the health educator, is the name of the channel, and we are going to talk about the safe days. We are going, having talked about ovulation, we are also going to answer a question that is commonly asked, and this question is, if at all we have this cycle and then give you, it's a 28 day cycle, how can you tell your safe days on basing on this method, basing on this particular cycle as an example? So having realized that the day of ovulation is the 14th day, and then of course 13th up to 15th, that is still ovulation taking place, the remaining days are they are your safe days. These are days you cannot get pregnant unless otherwise, but these are the days you are most likely not to get pregnant. Day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5, day 6, day 7, day 8, day 9, and day 10, giving day 11, we can give it a try, but always these days, including the days you've seen your periods, normally these are known as your safe days. When we reach here, these are your unsafe days because ovulation is taking place. The rest of the days, including day 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, up to when you see your periods again, that is up to the next time, the next first day you're seeing your periods, these are also known as your safe days. But remember, this method is not 100% perfect. We always advise that if you are using this method and you know that now you normally ovulate on the 14th day, we always advise that you supplement, you add on another family planning method. You could actually use this method, understand your ovulation date, but also look at adding on another family planning method. For example, you could choose, but normally we advise that you go to your family planning provider, either your midwife or your gynecologist, and discuss with them. They will take you through a study of the available family planning methods, and then the decision should be made between you and your couple, because remember, this is a family planning method. Family means you have to go with your partner and then decide on what appropriate method you should use. So today we have talked about how long does ovulation last. In this video, we've talked about how long does ovulation last, and we have said that specifically when ovulation has taken place on the 14th day, it lasts for 12 to 24 hours in your system. Ovulation lasts for 12 to 24 hours. Let me know if you have any questions down below in the comments. Thank you once again for being with me and for today's lesson. GERALD MASSA, the health educator, is our social media handle. You can always connect with me on my WhatsApp. It is +256 701 797 876. That is +256 701 797 876. You should also remember that the more you subscribe, the more we put out new videos. Remember, the YouTube algorithm will show you more of our videos. When you have subscribed, you'll be the first to watch the videos we put out every day. May God bless and protect us all, and see you in my next video. Remember, remember to read our description for details. I've put the details in regards to what we've talked about here in this video. So remember to go to the description. And our question for the day is, what did you learn in today's video? What did you learn in today's video? Share what you've learned in today's video in the comments below. And please, if you have any questions, please ask all your questions. I will answer them personally. But also, when you share your comments, when you share what you've learned in this video in the comments, it will help even other friends who will be coming to our channel. And remember, sharing is caring. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye. Thank you, my friend, for attending today's lesson. I hope you have learned something. And please, if you have any questions in regards to what we've just discussed, leave your questions in the comments. Ask me your questions. I will answer all your questions. On this channel, GERALD MASSA, the health educator, I talk about women's health. Have yourself a fantastic and healthy day, and may God bless us all. Bye-bye.